Yo, what's up, Pedro? And welcome to the stream, everybody. Welcome to the video on YouTube. Everybody's watching on YouTube. This is day 268, making song rear. I'm gonna switch back to show you what's up. Switch back to this certain game here. I got the top hat gate looking better. So this thing, I was working on this yesterday. You throw your top hat at it and it opens up some tiles. So when you first get to this screen, you can't walk to the north here. But if you throw your top hat at this thing, it reveals these tiles. And there's some splashy footsteps now too, and it would relieve some ripples and stuff. And it can even be work in reverse too, so if you go off the screen and come back, you can still hit it, just barely. Another thing, I fixed the top hat. So Pedro, finally, I finally fixed the top hat. So you can throw your top hat, go off the screen, and it'll actually come back to you still. You can even throw your top hat off the screen, run away to some other screen, go to another screen, and another one. Oh, you get the point. So the top hat's fixed, and also the top hat does not ever get stuck on exits anymore. So if you're throwing your top hat, it's not going to get stuck on like a rock or whatever, or an elevator, or the edge of the screen. And I think I fixed, yeah, right? It's finally, I know. And also, what else? There was some other bug I fixed. Anyways. Okay, I gotta set my frame rate a little lower. Okay, so yeah, the next thing is to work on the top hat sound when you open the inventory. No, I haven't got to that yet. That's on the list though, for sure. So there's a lot of bugs to fix with the inventory. It's all broken right now with its display, its zoom and all that, and also the map's broken. So there's a lot left to do there. I'm gonna have to focus, kind of hone in on that individually. So yeah, the next thing is to get these gates to look cool, and I like how this gate now has its own type of screen. It's got this water here in the middle and this edge around it, and the switches in the middle. But now I want to work on getting it on other types of areas. So like, for example, a west area or an east area. This needs to work, and you need to be able to hit the switch from just getting to the area, and you also need to be able to hit the switch from the reverse. So let's get to an area where that is gonna make sense. I'm gonna save my old save game there. I'm gonna switch the save game. It's active. The first one to that. This one down here. So it's gonna put me in a different place where there's a top hat gate to the left this time, or to the west. So works, but when you go off screen and come back, can't hit it anymore. So the next thing is to get this working, and I think the best way to get this working on this screen is to start off with making it so gates to the west. Make the gate rise above the water and level the grass. What do you mean level the grass? Or darken it. The reason I kept it under the water is because I can't change the reflection mask after I've already drawn to it. So it needs to stay reflective, and that's why I just wanted these sort of underwater moorings to come up. So what are you saying there about darkening it? Why would it be better to have darken it? And also, what do you mean by level the grass? Uh Okay, so getting the so when you when an area this screen right here needs to have its pathways to like to the west here where it has this gate, it needs that pathway to be centered instead of up there on the top of the screen. And there's another area pattern that uses that same type of technique, and that's with cliffs. Or stairs. Oh, all right. Let's try it. Maybe darken it by 25% at first. Wait for these textures to repack. Just a little bit better. Yeah, like I said, I can't do that because I can't edit the reflection mask afterwards. So if I were to do that, that's you know, that'd be great, but the it would still be reflective. You know what I mean? The those tiles that had risen above. Yeah, I could definitely change the shapes. Let's try a little more darkness. Didn't seem to help much. Supposed to have. Where does it load the mooring when it does a collision system activate? When you activate the switch, here's where it creates moorings. See, this should be loading a slightly random position for these. Maybe, but then, you know, that would kind of ruin the effect, because then you wouldn't be able to have water splashing and ripples and stuff, and I like that. Why didn't this work? What's up, Rocket Bunny? It should have, each one of these should have its own slight offset. It's not working at all. As I amp this up like a lot, like moving by, it's supposed to be 8 pixels there. Why isn't this working? Yeah, I like it the way it is, man. I like it this way. Oh, that's the problem. Okay. Oh, crap. What's going on? Alright, I don't know what. This kind of sucks to get this bug just now. What this is. It must have something to do with the new top hat fix to make the top hat can go off the screen and then come back on the screen, even if you move off the screen. So I think it's related to that. There's some new bug. I'm just set a note and it tells when I'm removing an EID here. Thanks, Rocket Bunny. Okay, so the movement is supposed to be. Okay. So the sprite needs its actual. It needs the movement plus a bit. So drandf, maybe times 2, this is drandf times 2, oh, this is drandf, not a 1, and then the movement is just, it moves 0 and 6, Happy Friday, everybody. Did anybody catch the Game Awards last night? I was pretty stoked to see Ori and the Blind Forest get nominated for. No, wait, did they win? They won Best Art. And then something else won. What else? Oh, Axiom Verge got nominated for Best Indie Game. That was pretty neat to see that. One guy, one man team, got nominated at the Game Awards. It's like the freaking Emmys. When's my birthday? It's coming up next week. Yeah, it's the day after Indy Cup. So next week's Thursday is Indy Cup. Friday's my birthday. You won the award Best 12-Year-Old? Yes. Best 12-Year-Old in the entire galaxy. Yeah. Yeah, the Trello board is that possibility's been on the been a consideration the whole time. Yeah, so I've been thinking about that. And that's one of the things why I need a little more time to get this updated alpha release out, because I really like to have that set up this time. So the next release I do for the alpha, I want to have a good system for reporting bugs and collaborating, contributing, and stuff like that, you know? Could make these integers. So DRAM 5, I think, would be 0, 1, 2, so that would be max of 4. If it was 4 plus negative 2, that would be plus 2. Yeah. And then this could just be DRAND. What's up, PMC? Yeah, good point. Yeah, the one concern I have about Trello is I'm wondering if it's if it can prioritize. Whoops, messed something up there. What? What did I do? BMC, yeah, the camera's moving. What's up, Lime Studios? What is wrong with this? Negative 2 plus DRAM 5. Wait, let's just put let's leave that one alone. What's up, Render Target? Welcome to the stream, man. What's a Prim's algorithm? Damn, this bug. Removing boomerang. Oh, so you removed it twice. So if we're here and if we're destroying it twice, what is this E? Man, it's hard to work when you got like, I was trying to work on one thing, now I'm working on another thing, and now I got a third thing that just came up. It's tough. I can't tell what, damn. I'm not sure why this is, why would this entity get called twice? Why would this? Oh, this is no longer right. Yeah, maybe. It's something you'll never use, but you're forced to learn. Maybe it was this. Hopefully it was that. It has to do with graphs. What's up, Sergeant Sam? Is there something which I would say is the hardest thing to learn in programming games? Really, that's kind of an individual thing, you know? Oh, now it works? This is so weird. Yeah, Sergeant Sam, I don't know, man. It kind of depends on you, you know? It's an opinion-based thing. If you're really looking just for my opinion on what I think is the hardest thing to learn, in programming games, I'd say real-time multiplayer is one of the hardest things you can do in making a video game. It'll eat up so much time and can be very difficult. Okay, there's nothing wrong with this. This is just negative 2 plus DRAM 5, mod 5. What? Why does this mess up when I do this? Well, hopefully I'll learn something here, figure out why this isn't working. Movement, offset, offset, schedule. This is going to be called multiple times. Pedro, good. I like that. The hardest thing in programming games is finishing a game. That probably is the absolute truth there. Yep, it's so true. Very few people actually finish their games. Oh yeah, PMC. Well, I don't know, is it or isn't it? Oh, Rocket League? Yeah, Lime Studios. I gotta wonder on that one too. Really? 'Cause I never played it. I never played Rocket League, but I was wondering. I'm like, what? This graphics on this did not seem like something that people would choose as a winner. My God. There you go. There's the problem. It's returning some gigantic value. Oh, don't tell me it's unsigned. Is this DRAND? It is unsigned. Oh man, this is just bugs waiting to happen right here. Okay, I need to fix this. Kid.h, this DRAND. You add in even this, get DRAND index. This should be int. DRAND should be int. Modulus. Modulus can be unsigned. Even get DRAND max. Well, nah. Okay, that's good. Good question on Undertale, yeah. Man, I hope this doesn't break everything. Flow DRAND max, DRAND. this does mess things up a little bit. Because if these values of the DRAND are higher than half, basically if they would turn out to be negative, then you could be returning a negative value with DRAND. What to do? I guess DRAND max needs to be maybe this shifted down one. What's up, Boogie? What's up, Real Small? Man, this is going to change every random number in the whole game if I do it this way. But this is pretty important that DRAND returns an integer value. Man, I guess it doesn't matter. I guess DRAND could return a negative value. No, I don't want it to return a negative value. So, ret DRANDs. I guess I could go int ret right here. Make that an integer. And then if it's less than zero, what am I thinking about? Okay, so there's I just ran into this bug. Where was I? Collision system. Yeah, I was here. So I did this. I did negative 2 plus DRAND 5. And I was really, okay, this should be negative 2 plus a random number between 0 and 4. That's what this needs to return. But since this is an unsigned value right here, this casts this to be unsigned. So DRAND 5 or negative 2 plus DRAND 5 turns out to be an unsigned value. And then you get this huge negative number right there, which is possible. So it's really wrong. I need DRAND to return an integer, but all the DRAND, the deterministic random numbers are unsigned. So I'm having a big debate here is what to do, how to return a value that's an integer. What do you do with all the data above that's a negative value, technically? Oh, so the votes for the Game Awards were from the audience? All right. So how do I get the maximum positive value? Oh. Right, yeah, that code isn't working feeling. That's what I'm having right now. I've got some good data here that's unsigned. I love it that way. I want this all this data to be. Okay, I kind of need both. I kind of need both these methods. So I'm going to do kit. I'm going to make a drand u method that's unsigned. And a regular drand is going to return an integer value. Yeah. Okay, and then so I can keep the old method. Drand u. And then make an integer version. Yeah. Oh, thanks, PMC. It's definitely my dream. From watching that last night, I'm like, I'd love to be on there one day. Love to be at least a nominee. That'd be great. But yeah, it was so great seeing Axiom Verge get at least nominated. Did Axiom Verge win anything? I don't know, but I saw them nominated and I was like, yes, that's super cool. A one man studio. Got a Game of the Year nomination. That's freaking awesome. All right, see you, PMC. Yes. Face off. Two different categories, though. I guess they would both be indies, right? But what's this? Okay, this is wrong. This could be returning a negative value. So I wanted to return a positive value. Right? I know. It'd be really hard for... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to expect. I don't know what to expect at all. What's up, Artemis? It's going good, man. Just running into a lot of bugs, though, all of a sudden. I wanted to do something today, and I got forced into doing all these other bug works. But anyways, this should be good to fix these bugs. All right, so I need the maximum integer. I need the maximum signed value. How would I get the maximum signed value besides using like numeric limits or whatever? There's a simple way. No, I haven't. Is there a new video out or something about Dark Souls 3? Oh, here it is, int max. Alright, so if red is less than 0, I think you just need to go red plus equals int max. I need to see this before I see it with a debugger. Oh, yeah, right. Polybridge, huh? I saw that one coming out. That was cool. Okay, here we go. We got a negative value. This is negative. I don't know what. If I add in int max. What the heck is int max? What do I get? It did return a positive value. Okay. And let's make int red the highest negative value, highest unsigned negative value we can get there. But using negative 1, no, that's not the high, wait. Oh, wait. We want in. What's it? Oh. Now another one of these days. Can't think. Negative one. I want the highest. Let's just see what that does. What's up, Jonah 19? Negative one. Max 2147. I say I want this to be negative 214. I want it to be the lowest negative. Wait. Don't want it to be negative one. I want it to be DRAN max. Yeah, DRAN max. Right. And then I think that'll be return a negative value. It should return the highest negative value. Oh yeah, I guess that works. And then re add one. Oh, so that did work. So, but is that right? Whoa, rage quit. Damn, dude, I'm sorry. Jonah, here's what the issue is I'm working on. It's very simple. All I wanted was a negative. Okay, I got this number. I want a number between negative two and positive two. But I found this bug today, which is huge. This is a critical bug. If because DRAN, the old DRAN method returned an unsigned value. So if you did negative two plus an unsigned value, it casted this negative two to an unsigned value, which returned a huge number. So this returns a huge number instead of something between negative two and two. And so all I need to do is make DRAN return an integer value. So it's safe to use in simple little expressions like that. The big problem, though, with changing the way DRAN behaves is that DRAN is the most fund one of the most fundamental functions in this entire game. This is the deterministic random number generator. This is how everything in the world is generated. Every decision in the whole game boils down to this function. So I need this to be right, and so I feel a lot of pressure with making this right. And so I'm trying to, first of all, if I do want to do this, I need to fix all the other methods that are already using DRAND so that they use DRAND U, that which are the ones that need to use the unsigned version, and then the int version, will become, I just need to fix so that negative values are handled properly. Just delete the lines of code which don't work. Everywhere that calls DRAND. Matching case. Nice. Nice. Thanks, Rocket Bunny. Okay, so I'm gonna check over every. Let's just replace all. Compile. And now I can go and hand check over every one of these to make sure that this one, this should be the unsigned version versus the integer version. So DRAND U. See, when you're modding it by a size, it doesn't matter whether you use the U or the I version. But I guess I'll use the U version by default. Yeah. Easy 50 euros. Yes, yeah, 64 bucks right there. Bam. I'm just going to convert these to use just the DRAND version because it's a little more simple. Wait, what's wrong with that? Why is it giving me an error now? Double down. Is GitHub useful? Heck yeah. You can share your code. People can submit stuff to help you fix your code, make it better. You can benefit other people huge. Like you write a little simple project, put it on GitHub, and you could be benefiting thousands of people. Who knows? Oh. Yeah, get a book out, man. Heck yeah, that's gotta be some kind of, what are those things called that they, a rite of passage, that's it. A GitHub account is a rite of passage, Rocket Bunny. You're now entering into the new world. Nice. So here's one that needs to be DRAM'd to you. I think. No, this is just RMod 9. You know, this doesn't matter if it's DRAM or DRAM U. Is one definitely should be DRAM. What's a code repository? It's universal. It's not just on GitHub. A code repo is something you check code into, and it keeps the differences that you've checked in. It's like source control. Now here's one that should be unsigned. Guess that could be unsigned, unsigned. Oh, this is pretty important. This generates all the random numbers for all the tiles. And yeah, this definitely should be DRAM U, even though it's only doing it for 255 values. Yeah, these should all be DRAM U. This one, definitely not. It should be DRAM. Yeah, good point, Evermore. Bitbuckets is an alternative to GitHub that allows you to do free private repos if you're a small team, and which is pretty cool. Here we go. This is the whole reason I did this. So I could do DRAN instead of DRAN U there. And then back to this is a pretty important one there. Guess that one should be signed. Oh, cool. This one's important here. Rands, unsigned. Okay, yeah, DRAND U is appropriate for that. Randomize elements. We'll create, what is this? Oh yeah, DRAND use fine here. So what should this one be? This R. All right, cross my fingers this works, and I need to figure out what's up with the negative, with the breakpoint, with the negative values, and then I think it's good to go. All right. So, if everything's working here, I didn't break the world. Okay, that's a good sign that I'm in this exact same area, because that could have broken everything. Could have destroyed the entire world. Looks like we still have a refill here. That's good. Okay, here we go. Oh, we're breaking. No, I need a break here. What? Why is it removing the same boomerang over and over and over? Now we're back to the other bug. Okay, I can't deal with two bugs at once. That's crazy. Okay, so if red is less than zero, red plus equals int max, I guess that's fine. Because int max is always going to be a little more than the highest integer value you could get. So negative one would be the same value as like 2001, blah, 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 2 million or whatever. So I guess it doesn't really matter, because if you're gonna only have half the random numbers, you know, I'm gonna be explicitly using this method when necessary, so I guess it's okay to do it just like that. Okay. Pro Tito, no, not at all. It's really hard to talk in code. It's incredibly hard. And you see me struggle, like on a day like today where I'm having all these bugs hit me at once and I'm trying to talk. It's like, it gets really, really difficult. And so it's actually just 2 hours of live streaming can leave me tireder than anything else. So it's difficult to do, and I definitely wouldn't recommend it. You know, unless you really have to, or unless you really want to stream and you want to get all the benefits of streaming, you know, then it becomes worthwhile, I guess. But yeah, it's hard to talk in code. Right? Yeah. Yeah, you can talk to yourself, but narrating everything you do is a trip, man. It's a brain trip. You're going in a totally different area. Wow, nice, dude. You refactored less code. Cool, man. It looks really good, too. Awesome. Good job, man. Okay, I can verify where collision system. This, I could verify this by using DRAND U right here and should break some of those tiles. Nice. There, yeah, it broke some of them. Cool. Okay, there. Man, unexpected bug number one. Just took an hour of the stream there, but at least that's a hell of a lot better. We've got signed DRAND, we've got unsigned DRAND. They're explicitly different methods. So this should now see all these here. Yeah, cool. Got them all. Alright. What? What's it? What did I miss? What? Oh, which is better, Coco's camera or making your own? I know, it's so hard to find useful information because Coco Studio X has like all these different new ways of doing your camera in every version lately. It's like At 3.0, they took away the camera, and then they're like, okay, but you can still use these matrix transformations on top of the camera position or whatever. There's like so many different ways. I just recommend doing your own because Cocos is probably going to change it and break it if you use their camera. You know, maybe in 4.0 they'll finally land on a camera style that they'll use and exclusively, but probably not. So I'd recommend doing your own. Okay, back to what I was working on. Okay, I think I can tackle this next bug now. Either that or just start working on. Oh, I think I finally realized why. Why I was getting this bug. Is this right? If I set a breakpoint there and then play and maybe disable this breakpoint. Yeah, see there, it tries to remove the boomerang a bajillion times. Where are they from? Okay. Oh, how to solve this one? Let's see. Let's go to where it's removing the boomerang. At this tick. Oh, nice. Ah, nice boogie, right? That was old stuff. Ah. Yep. Yeah, and that was that, and it plateaued. That beard was like a year or 2 years into it, and it was the same length it was a year before that, so I got sad and shaved it all off. I'm like, man, my beard. I was really hoping to have a wizard beard. I'm like, dude, I want a beard just like Gandalf. But it didn't work. What's up? Why am I getting a Oh no, game show's eating it. Eating all the CPU. What's your problem, game show? Trying to ruin the stream, aren't you? Oh, now it's not. Okay, so if I enable this again. Right? If I had a Gandalf beard, dude, you guys would be seeing it grow longer and longer every year. Artemis, no, I do not have a day job. I started this whole project with no money, and I did a successful Kickstarter. So thank you once again, everybody that backed the Kickstarter. So that's enabled me to get to this point. This is my life. I'm making this game, and I don't have any other job or anything. If I did have a day job, there's no way I'd be this far with this game. I've only been working on this a year, but like, this is a full-time effort. Yeah, I guess it is the dream, right? Sometimes it feels like a dream come true. Sometimes it feels like, it being a game developer, you can feel really under appreciated because you work so much. I work 7 days a week. I work 10 to 12 hours a day. I'm barely making any money. Like, no, literally, I'm making almost no money. The Kickstarter was great. I'm not trying to take away from it or anything like that. But the amount of money I'm living on is so small every month that it's not exactly peace of mind. So I really do hope this game succeeds financially so that I can kind of have some more peace of mind and feel more appreciated. But anyways, sorry. End rant, end rant. Game development's hard in many different ways. Just gotta, do it because you love it, not because it's super rewarding. I guess it is rewarding, it's just rewarding in different ways. Nice, Artemis, cool, man. Right, exactly. That's exactly it. The life of an indie developer, it kind of sucks, but it also rocks. It's amazing that I can wake up every day and do literally whatever I want. I can be like, okay, today I don't want to make a new enemy, or I do want to do this new gate or whatever. Whatever I want to do, I can do it. And that's the best part. Right? Boogie says do it because everything else sucks. Yeah, there's lots of ways of looking at that, and your attitude makes a huge difference on how far you get with your project. If you really do love making games, you'll probably finish one. But if you get stuck at some point and you're like, man, I don't want to keep making this game. Maybe I'll just give up. Maybe I won't make this game. Then you're not going to, and that's like we were just talking about that earlier in the stream. Somebody said, "What's the hardest thing about game development?" And it looks like it. Finishing a game probably is one of the hardest things there is. Most people never finish the games that they make. It's like a box of chocolates, right? Okay, here's an idea how I can fix that other bug. Game scene. Remove free id. Make this return a bool on whether it did remove the free id, and then got another method, void, destroy free id. Nice. Jonah, see, right? Yeah. That's one of the toughest things, is finishing a game. If you're somebody that's ever finished a video game, that's commendable. That's amazing. Yeah, good question. Right? What is this factor that causes some people to stop their games? There. Okay, so there's a better method here, which destroys a free EID. A free EID is a thing that is independent of an area. What's up, Adam Hunter? Yeah, and then there's also, you know, some people have full-time jobs, you know, and other response. Maybe you have a full-time job and a family, you know? That's tough. Then it's really, really tough to find the time to make games because games take so much time. So much time. There we go. Okay, so we remove this and we'll go game. We'll use the destroy EID method this time. Okay, let's hope this works to fix this other bug. Okay, so now I need to re-turn on breakpoints here. Run it till it hits that. Run it past that. Yeah. Yeah, starting a project that's too ambitious is, yeah, that can definitely be a showstopper. And that's why I always recommend anybody that's just getting started in game development to check out those extra credit videos, because it's one of the first points they hammer home is that you should scope small. Scope your game, especially the first game you ever make. Make it the smallest game you possibly can. Oh, hey, it worked. All right, it worked. Okay, there. Now I've gotten rid of two bugs today. And I think, okay, now I'm finally back to the point where I can actually start on what I was starting on at the beginning of the freaking stream an hour and a half ago. Well, all I wanted to do was to make it so this exit over here is centered. So you hit this. Let me show you guys the other exit that I was at. This one, or the other. This is an exit to the north. What's up, Spymort? Does your game work on a 75 hertz or 144 hertz monitor? I guess so. I don't see why it wouldn't. Do you mean does it run faster? Basically, yes, you can set the game to run at whatever max FPS you want. And, you know, by default that's going to be 60, but you can turn that up to like 90 or whatever. I haven't got that to actually work above 60. There's some cap, there's some frame rate cap in Cocos 2DX. But I'll find it, and then I'll fix that, and so this can be above 60. They have self-aware heroes. So yeah, I like the way this one looks. This one looks great. You know, you come in from this screen. You come in from off the screen like this way. And then you can't get up there. You can't get past this. So you have to figure it out. You have to use your top hat to hit this thing. And then you can walk across, splash your way across here and get up here. And you can come back too. So if you come back on this screen, you can still hit it, just barely. So okay, I'm trying to bring all that beauty right there into a westward facing area. Right. Suck it in, man. Suck it in. Okay. So to move this stuff up here, this gate here, these underwater moorings, these things. If I want to move these to the center of the screen, there's a lot that has to fundamentally change in this area. And because it needs to match up with the area to the left of it and maybe to the right of it as well. So I need to look at some other code first. Thanks, Bymore. I should probably check in what I've done so far as well. Because this is all fundamental, super fundamental stuff. That's weird. DRAN-U, remove free id, destroy free id, get DRAN index. I'm just reviewing my code I just wrote. All right. So DRAN versus DRAN U. All right, there. That water is under the bridge. Hey, thanks, Proton Gaming. Yeah, Proton Gaming, this is C++. And yes, it's C++ 11, a little bit of C++ 14. You can tell I'm using C++ 11 because I've got auto and I've got lambdas. Okay. So, onward, on to the next thing. How long do we have left today? Half an hour. All right. There's a special, it's called isOpenPath, area patterns. There's an isOpenPath, isOpenInterior, isOpenPath. This thing depends on. I'm trying to look at, there's a, oh, see that there. If not. Stairs. This is an important thing to get right. K flag stairs. Yeah, Adam Hunter, don't worry about it, man. Just start small. Start really small with everything. Keep everything scoped as really, really tiny. It's like learning to make games is quite a complex affair. What you want to do is just start with the smallest things you can possibly do, and don't worry about coding so much. When you're learning to make games, don't focus so much on code at first. Focus on the overall game. So you want to use something really simple like Game Maker or maybe Unity, or Construct, one of those engines where you don't even have to code really. But you can code if you need to. And then start with some simple tutorials with those game engines. until you get familiar with it. And so what you're learning there is you're learning the overall process of making a game. You're learning to make art a little bit. You're learning maybe a tiny bit of code. You're learning more about how to arrange entities and how the overall game loop will work and things like that. And those kind of things are more important, I think, than learning to code at first. So yeah, so man, just relax. If you love to make games, it'll all flow. It'll all come, man. Right? How many lines of code are there so far? I'm probably above 40,000 now. Yeah, 42,000. God damn. I wish I could make that less. Taiho, that's right. Yes, Taiho. Yes, exactly. You do remember things visually in ways when you're coding. No, Boogie, that does not include Cocos. Cocos is a whole nother thing. Cocos is, how big is Cocos? I don't know how many lines of code Cocos is. Yeah. Because I don't know how do you do a recursive word count? I would do that, but I don't know. Cocos is probably at least 100,000 lines of code. All right. So there's this thing that centers the open path. So I'm trying to mimic the same behavior as the stairs. The stairs have this ability to center their path. Yeah, okay. This is where it all happens. This is where it decides whether a path is centered or not. So west and east happens if So this is the direction is west. The quadrant is either southwest or northwest. It centers the path if the southwest quadrant has a west and a north. And the area to the west has east and north in its southeast quadrant. All right, so that means that here's the area I'm on, I think. This is area Herman, right? I want to make sure this is the right one. Yeah, thanks, man. Let's try it out. Okay, let's see. I've got a repo of CocoStudiX separate from Songbringer. Yeah, find dot dash name. Cool. Nice, dude. Ah, this is a nice solution. I like this. It uses the OR. I've never used the OR thing with find. Pipe it into xargs. Wow, see that? 150,000 lines. 150K. That's just in CocoStudiX. So, yeah, there's a lot. Indivisible? What's indivisible? It's a game? Oh, I think I saw this one, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, the Skullgirls one. Right, right. Okay, so Titmouse is doing it? I didn't know Titmouse was doing that. Yeah, 200,000 lines, I guess. I'm not really counting this as part of Songbringer. But yeah. 200,000, but it is 200,000 lines of code that I'm aware of, sort of. You know, I'm semi-aware of those 150,000 in there. Okay, so let's verify the first. The maze is still the same. I think what I need to do to center the path for this area, for any kind of gate in general, is that I need to change the way the gate is actually, the openings in the maze. Oh, it did change everything since yesterday. Oh, it just changed the placement of a couple things. I don't know why it did, though. Oh, right. Yeah, I know that one. Yeah. So Titmouse is making the animations for that. That's awesome. Dude, Titmouse, one of my favorites lately. Oh, Adam Hunter. No, that's definitely not a stupid question. I wish I could help you with it, though. I don't know what I don't use Android Studio or Blender, so. Yeah, I need these maps. These are really important because there's 300 million worlds. I need at least some insight into them. Okay, so I think what needs to happen is I need to change the... For example, this area right here is the one we're looking at, right? I think if I just change this path so it's down here and not there, I think that's all that needs to happen, and it will center the path automatically. Let's try it out. Let's see if we can do some maze magic wizardry. Maze generator where it's placing gates. place gates, possible gates, chosen gates, remove corners, choose gates, place gates. This is post, I think. Yeah, no, this is pre. This is the pre. Okay, all right, this is kind of tricky. So I wanted to connect there. Oh, I okay. Instead of trying to do it before it creates all these, it probably would be best to do it after it creates all the gates. So in post, I think this would be a good place to do this. Okay, here. Well, let's spiffy up the gates now. So gates, we'll say we're going to center all the gate paths. So loop over every area. If this has a gate flag, okay, I'm going to make a small function that will make this easier. So if it has the flag gate, I'm going to call a new function called this center paths or center exits, maybe center. Yeah, center paths is fine for X, Y. Okay, so maze.h, add this method, center paths. It's a private method, set open. Center paths. Okay, so while that's compiling, I need this method, it's like set openings, so I'm going to put it near set openings. Nice, Pedro. Good find. Okay, so this method is going to loop over every direction if it has an opening the autocomplete's not even working. X, Y, D. There. So if it's not open, continue. So now we just verified that this is a this area, this X, Y area has an opening in that direction. Now, if it does have any opening and it has a, well, we're not looking at gates. We just want to set this to be a centered path, which means that we want to use the lower path. The southwest versus the northwest. So if the direction we're talking about is horizontal, I guess we'll loop over. Hey, good night, Jonah. Yeah. Pedro, dude, that's so true. So true. That should definitely be a college class. Searching with Google, effectively. Come on. I mean, this is basic stuff, right? Yes. I love that one. Wait, what are the answers it gave to that one? Dude, I love that. Come on, what does it get? How to search on Google, the Google Help Center. All right, center of the paths. Well, I guess this could be just All right, this is one of these dirty methods I gotta write once, dirty, and then refine and make it better later. So the quadrant we're talking about here, quadrant is D plus I. So for example, if we're going south, well, let's start with west. West is 1. 1 plus 1 or 1 plus 0 would be southwest. Plus 1 would be northwest. So yeah, those are the two quadrants we're talking about. So we need to get the x2, y2. Given X, given Y, the direction. No, that's not right. The quadrant. Output to X2, Y2. Set open squared in that quadrant, in the direction. The first one, I equals 0. Oh, I just realized what this could be. So, this is the int open index equals, if it's horizontal, we're going to be looking to open the first index. If it's vertical, we're opening up the second index. We loop over both indices independent of direction. This is I equals open index. Ah, I think that this might work. Why not negative one for west and one for east? Because there's four directions. There's northwest, east, and south. Hangover jam. You wake up and code. If the game works, you win. That's awesome. If you need a topic, I have one in mind. That's awesome. Yeah, right. All right, well, let's try it out. See what we get. It's gonna build this. It's gonna should it should center all the paths for the maze. We'll see. I'm gonna step through this code once before I run it, so it yeah, definitely best way to start the year. Right, what path? What is this? X1, Y0. All right, this is exactly the path that we wanted to open up. So we're here. We're here, this path. Okay, so it should loop through the directions. Okay, so south, it didn't like, of course, so there's no opening to the south. But here we're at west. Okay, so the open index, if the direction is west or east, which it is going to be, then it's going to return the open index is going to be zero. So it loops over both directions. Current quadrant is one, which is quadrant southwest, X2, Y2, 2, 0, set open squared if I is equal to open index. Bool opens true, good. Next time, quadrant is now two, which is northeast or northwest. Set open squared should be false. Right, good. And that's it. That's there should be no more. Well, actually, oh, there's gonna be more openings. Oh, this needs to work on. Oh, this needs to work on both this path and the path it connects to. Yeah, right. Oh, it's woke up. Okay, one bug so far, and that's that this needs to open up the corresponding path, which is adder direction to x2, y2. We set the open squared in the reverse direction. So dir d plus 2. Okay, and this time, okay, I'm gonna let it run. We'll let it run through the first one, and then we'll catch it the next time, see what happens with a different direction. So now we've got X3, Y1. This is 1, 2, 3, 1. can't be right. 3-1. What? Okay, I'm gonna run this. I'm gonna run it without even checking it because I'm confused. I'm confused because that 3-1 shouldn't have had a gate. Still doesn't have a gate. Then running it without checking is the best way to check it. Yeah, it's my favorite way to check it. That's for sure. All right, it broke. It broke the gate north 8. That one's broken now. Okay, so if I wait. So here's everything that had changed. Okay, so there's definitely some problems. Oh, because it needs the center paths only for a certain direction. Okay. So first of all, this needs the center paths. This method needs a direction. So paths can be centered only in a certain direction. Rather than centering everything. Right. Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally. Why would you do that to yourself? I think there's a get gate direction. Oh, this is the gate type. Oh man, I know there's a method for getting a gate direction somewhere. I know I wrote this. Where did I put it? Oh, it's just has gate. If it has a gate in that direction. Oh, okay. Has gate. So this needs to loop over every direction. For each direction, if this has gate. There. Center path. Now center paths need to be the center path instead of paths. Right? Well, let's call this center openings now. Actually, that's a better name, I think. Goes along with these other openings here. All right, let's hope this works. It's a long stream to do a tiny thing. I solved two bugs that were totally unrelated, and now all I'm trying to do here is get this one path to open up and be like low instead of high. What? Why did this recompile? I know, SpyMart, right? Yeah, it does happen all the time. I mean, I guess this last thing I'm working on here isn't really a bug. It's more of a feature where I'm trying to make it so it centers the path if there's a gate. So, you know, that's kind of a feature, but those other two bugs, they were hard to find. It took me an hour and a half just to fix those. But yeah, so I'm getting close to being done with the stream today. I'm gonna get this last thing fixed, and if this works, man, I'm gonna rejoice. But if not, I'm probably gonna have to cut this stream short after that anyways. Hopefully this works. I got a slow compile day. I don't know what's up. My computer's just like lagging. Right, yeah, it's true. Thanks, Bymore. Thank you for helping me look at this the right way. An hour and a half is really not that long for a bug. Right. Yes, like a day and a half to like 2 days and a half. Totally. Born to snipe, right? Haven't we all been there? I think any game developer has been there. Any developer, shit. If you're a coder in any language, you probably spend at least a day working on a single bug, if not more. Oh, wait, I think it might have worked. You lost 8 hours trying to find a bug in a grid traversal algorithm and decided to delete it, right? That's cool, dude. I like that's a really bold strategy, Pedro. You worked all day, you couldn't find it, so you just deleted it and you're gonna try again. That's a really cool way to do it, because when you try again, when you start from scratch again, it's like sometimes that's exactly what you need. CSS, that's all. Okay, so here's what it used to look like. Here's what it looks like now. Oh, I think it totally worked. Okay, so that does work. Okay, there's a couple issues I want to look at here. The first gate is perfect. The bottom left one, GW2. Let's circle all the places where it has these gate changes now, to kind of make this obvious. There's a gate north. There's a gate. Yeah. Get reset head hard. Oh, that's nervous. It makes me nervous just even reading that. Oh, wait, no, that's just resetting one commit. Sorry. I was like, dude, is that deleting the whole repo? Of course it's not. Whoa. Permadeath code mode. You know what? I think this is okay. It only affected the gates that it needed to, and it only opened up area, or it just made the area so they will be centered. Oh no, that one's wrong. East is wrong. Yeah, both of these east ones are wrong. Okay, so east is a little different. Center openings for the east path. Actually, I think it just needs to be that. Yeah, there you go. That scares me now, Born to Snipe, for sure. RM dot SRF dot git. Screw it all. So I gotta tell this funny story. When I was a kid, I was really interested in my grandma's DOS computer. I was like, wow, what is this? And I was like, DOS, whoa, cool, commands, whoa, black screen, white text, you know what I mean? DOS, super old school. 80, it was probably like 1987 or something like that. And I grabbed the manual. I'm like, oh, I want to learn all the commands I can type in. I grab the manual, flip it open to the first command I find. First command I find, format. The example, format C colon. I ended up typing actually format A colon, thankfully. I don't know why, but I actually totally deleted one of my games when I was a kid. I was like, what? No. I guess I did that. That was a TLDR moment. I was like, oh no, why didn't I read the whole manual? Right? Don't we all have this story? Tell me we all have this story. Tell me I'm not the only one. Yes. I love that guy. I know, right? You would be screwed. Your speech is crap. Right? Okay, so the only kind of gate we're not seeing here is a gate to the south. Well, let's I'm gonna step through the what it would do if it was south. So if it was the direction south, it would say open index equals D equals west. So that'd be no. It would be open index is one for south, which would mean you would wanna do. Oh, south also is one. Right, so the direction is south, open index is 0. Yeah, I think that's right. Okay, time to see if this worked. Right, thankfully, I started with A colon. Felix DJ, what's up, man? Have I ever suffered from imposter syndrome? Yeah, what is that? Hey, it worked. Let's check it out. Oh, it totally works. See the center, the path is centered over there. But here's the trick, because can you get your, oh, what happened? Why don't you have your hat on, dude? Oh, thanks, Lime. It's a term coined in the 70s by psychologists, researchers, people who are unable to internalize their accomplishments. Despite external evidence of their competence, those exhibiting the syndrome remain convinced that they are frauds and do not deserve the success they've achieved. Proof of success is dismissed as luck, timing, result of deceiving others. Oh, right, yeah. No, I don't really have that problem that much. I know I've experienced feelings of sort of unworthiness or undeservingness, in general, but never really what I would consider imposter syndrome. But I know this is a common thing, and in almost all, I don't know, I think almost all self-esteem issues boil down to issues of non-deservability or, what do you, just things that you feel like you don't deserve it, so I know that's a really important thing to deal with. And I just, if you're that kind of person, if you're in that kind of situation right now where you kind of have an imposter syndrome, I really would recommend checking out this article I wrote about how to tune your mind. It's Wizard Fu Tuning the Mind. You're gonna have to search for this on Google because I'm not gonna be able to type this whole link or whatever on my iPad over there. But search for this. Look for Wizard Fu Tuning the Mind, and this is all about how you can tune your mind away from having those kind of weird problems and fears and issues and stuff. So check that out. That might help. And this is my process for dealing with any kind of psychological issue. And I'll tell you, I have psychological issues all the time. Probably once a week, once every 2 weeks maybe. I have some kind of fear or something that just messes me up. I'm like, dude, I'm afraid of doing that, or it's a gripe I have or some complaint or something like that. And I use this constantly, at least once a week, where I'm dealing with some other kind of fear or belief or something that might that could potentially stop everything. You know what I mean? Psychology is one of the most important bits of any activity I think you do, especially with creative activities. So maybe check that out if you are having that issue, any kind of psychological issue. Oh, right, the TED link. Yeah. That's a good one for Amanda Palmer. Thanks, Boogie. Recommend me a course? Sure, of course. Yeah, Hilbert. So check it out. I'm just about to stop the stream here. But this is what the game looks like now. So I've been working on this little top hat gate. So you get to this point on this level, like let's say you're over here. Right? You come across this area. Oh, what's this? It's like a switch in the middle of the water, and you hit it, and it releases some underwater moorings to come up, and then you can walk across the underwater moorings. So that's what that is. And yeah, there's lots of new stuff in the game. I don't really have time to play it right now, but yeah. So the next thing I'll do to work on this is to make it so you can. Why is it not catching the hat anymore? Well, that was weird. It was jittering. Okay, but yeah, so that's it for today's stream. Got a couple bugs fixed. I'm still gonna work. What I need to do next is make it so that path is just indented a little bit, and then it'll be better. Oh. Yeah, Born to Snipe, I did. Yeah. So check it out. There's yeah. It's got little. And also you can, if you listen closely, the sound when you walk on ground is like a normal footstep noise, and then when you walk on water, it makes little splashy noises and stuff. So, that's it for today's stream. I'll be back tomorrow, Wizard 30, working on Songbringer the next day. So we'll see how many more bugs I can squash tonight. Oh, you couldn't hear the sound for the game all day? Oh, damn. Oh, all right. Well, I'll try and work on that tomorrow. Yeah, so see you guys. Have a good one.